The A-list fashion parade has begun. The biggest stars in movies are gathering along Hollywood Boulevard for the most glamorous event of the year. They're ready to celebrate in style as the best films of 2018 are immortalized with gold at the 91st Academy Awards. This is Oscars Live on the Red Carpet. And now, please welcome Ashley Graham, Billy Porter, Elaine Welteroth, and Maria Menounos.
Hi, everyone. Maria Menounos here, welcoming you to Oscars Live on the Red Carpet. Joining me for the star-studded arrivals are Billy, Elaine, and Ashley. Welcome to you guys. Thank you.
Are you ready?
Thank you so much.
I'm so ready. This is the time of my life.
You look ready. I can't wait.
I can't wait to keep staring at your outfits. You guys look incredible. But I know you have to get to your positions.
Yes. So head on out.
Have a great show.
Thank you. See you later.
I'll see you later.
We'll see you.
In the meantime, we are getting ready for exclusive interviews with some of tonight's nominees and presenters. This is the hottest ticket in town. Hollywood Boulevard is packed with fans hoping to catch a glimpse of the stars. And journalists from all over the world are looking forward to chatting with everyone. But you, my friends, hi, Mom, you have the best seat in the house for an up-close and personal experience. Now let's see who's arrived on the red carpet.
We are here with one of the most hilarious actresses in Hollywood and one of my personal faves, Awkwafina.
Hey.
Welcome to the red carpet.
Thank you. It's an out-of-body experience. It's so cool.
Well, I have to tell you, you look incredible.
Thank you so much.
I actually wish I was wearing that tonight.
I know.
You did it right in a pantsuit. You're comfortable.
So I have to tell you,
you are my favorite character in Crazy Rich Asians.
Oh, my God. Thank you.
And hilarious in Ocean's 8. But this is your first time at the Oscars. What does it feel like?
I mean, it's surreal. I was just telling my team as I was getting ready, when I was young, I would watch the Oscars every year, and I wish that I could come. You know, I thought that I'd maybe be, I don't know, working it or something, but I had no idea that I'd be here.
You're so amazing. You're representing. Yeah. You're looking stunning.
Thank you. You look very stunning, too.
Thank you, sis. I appreciate it. Yeah. So your next project is the sequel for Jumanji.
Yes, it is.
Which we cannot wait for. And I know that your co-stars are some of the funniest guys in Hollywood.
Yeah,
Kevin Hart,
they're kind of like no-name actors. I don't think a lot of people have heard of them.
You know? But you have to tell us, what's the real deal? Who's the funniest? Behind the scenes.
That's hard. I mean, I'd have to say Jack Black. He makes me laugh, dude. He's hilarious. Yeah.
I would vote for you, but thank you so much for joining us. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Have fun tonight. All right, Ashley. Let's see who you're talking to on the red carpet over there, girl.
Adam Lambert, looking so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Who gave you this fresh beat? Because it is good.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's just moisturizer.
You look so good.
Thank you.
And the ear candy, I'm all about ear candy.
Thank you.
Okay, so you've performed in this theater before, and tonight you're actually performing with Queen.
Yes.
What does this feel like for you tonight?
It is, you know what, it's mind-blowing. It's surreal. I've lived in Los Angeles for about 17 years, and to be a part of the Oscars is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And to perform with Queen, the band that I've been on the road with for 6 years.
Right.
They're my family. We've done a ton of shows around the world, but to play the Oscars together in celebration of Bohemian Rhapsody is such a dream.
And speaking of Bohemian Rhapsody, you were actually in the movie.
Yeah, for like a second.
Okay,
if you blinked, you might have missed me. I was the trucker.
Okay.
Tempting Freddie at the restroom.
Oh my God, I remember that.
Yeah.
I'm totally going to go back and pause it and take a picture.
I was just repping for all gay temptation.
Yeah. Well, I enjoyed the movie.
Thank you. I'm so excited
to see you perform tonight.
Oh, I'm so excited to be up there.
Great. All right, Elaine, what you got cooking over there, girl?
As we talk with the presenters and hopeful nominees, we're also going to get an inside track on tonight's competition for the acting categories. First up, tonight's nominees for actor in a supporting role.
Mahershala Ali, Green Book.
You never win with violence, Tony. You only win when you maintain your dignity. Dignity always prevails.
Adam Driver, Black Klansman.
Chief, it's not about that, you know it. If he recognizes his voice, if any of the Klansmen do, it'll compromise our entire investigation.
Sam Elliott, A Star Is Born.
You're not going to get back what you lost. It's the only way we can manage what you still got.
Richard E. Grant, Can You Ever Forgive Me?
Do not underestimate sparkly blue eyes and a little bit of street smarts. They go a long way in this city.
Sam Rockwell, Vice.
So long as you don't mind us pushing that messaging, we're okay with you sending that one out. I think it's important for all the Marys in the world.
Okay, we have some heavy hitters in this category, but we could also have a surprise winner. Joining me with her expert opinion on this race is film critic and Turner Classic Movies host, Alicia Malone, who is here to talk about these nominees.
Yes.
What are you thinking?
Well, this is the category where we could see the biggest surprise in the form of Richard E. Grant for Can You Ever Forgive Me? And it's been such a joy to watch him go through this award season. He's been having the best time, as he should, for his first Oscar nomination in his long career of making movies. And fun fact, Sam Rockwell was actually cast in his role years ago in Can You Ever Forgive Me?
Really?
And he's up against Sam Rockwell tonight for Vice and Sam Elliott for A Star Is Born and Adam Driver for BlacKkKlansman. But the man to beat and the one that I'm predicting will take this category is Mahershala Ali for Green Book. Stoic, powerful performance. Yes. And he has been really sweeping all the awards so far. He's got a lot of support behind him. And if he wins tonight, he'll be winning his second Oscar, and that will make him only the second black actor to ever win two Oscars after Denzel Washington.
Wow. Okay, well, my fingers are crossed. I am rooting for Mahershala. Thank you so much, Alicia.
Thank you.
And Alicia will be back with more on the other acting nominees. Now let's check out more stars on the red carpet.
I am here with the incredible Regina King. Aww. I am so excited to see you.
I'm so excited to be here. I'm so excited to see you.
Thank you. You know, I remember seeing your manager and he was like, this is going to be Regina's year. Aww. I'm like, I hope so. I hope so. It's your first nomination.
It is.
You've been working since you were 14. Did you envision this in your teenage moments?
You know, it is so interesting. I can't say that I didn't envision it. You know, I think I've always felt success was part of God's path, mm-hmm. you know, for me. But, you know, here we are. I think what's more the thing that I didn't envision, that I would be here representing James Baldwin. That is just still mind-blowing to me, that it's the first American film adaptation of his work. Mm-hmm. And to be here representing that, I still get chills.
So incredible. You had an incredible performance. What do you hope people take away from the film?
I guess that love is a universal thing, that's what gets us through traumatic experiences, no matter what gender, no matter what race you are, no matter what age you are, we can all relate to that, that's what pulled us through.
Yep.
I mean, one of the taglines in the film are trust love all the way, is trust love all the way. So I hope people take that away from it and remember that's how we've gotten through.
Yep. I love it. Well, good luck tonight. You look incredible.
Thank you.
I hope you have an amazing night.
I'm already here.
Yes. Yes, you are.
It's already amazing.
You are. Have a great night. Good luck. And Billy, who do you got?
Oh my God, I'm fangirling here with Michelle Yeoh. Look at the vision that stands before me. You are stunning this evening.
Oh, thank you. How
kind. We hear that you had hesitation about this part. What made you change your mind?
Hesitation about what?
Hesitation about the part that you played in Crazy Rich Asians.
Why? Because I don't want mothers to come across as being villains.
Right.
Like they're just being mean and nasty.
Right.
All mothers, I want to say, their motivation is from love.
Yes.
Right? They want to protect their child. They
Absolutely.
Want to make sure that whoever they choose will be right for them because it's supposed to last forever and
Absolutely.
Ever.
Absolutely.
So she did it out of love.
Right.
And,
Absolutely.
And I think at the end of the day, it's also helping the girl find her self-worth.
Yeah.
It's like if you can stand up to the challenge, then you would be perfect as
Absolutely.
My daughter-in-law.
Absolutely. And that showed through, and I love this movie. What about the jewels? You wore your own ring?
Yes, I did.
Can we compare rings?
Oh, my God.
Compare the jewels,
I need
darling.
Okay, wait a minute.
Okay, who made this dress?
Elisab.
It's stunningly beautiful. We thank you.
Thank you for gracing
us with your presence. And let's go on and see what shenanigans are happening on the red carpet.
This is your first chance to see all of the stars in their Oscar night looks. We're just getting started, and we've got a lot of exclusive interviews to come right here on ABC.
That's Hollywood Boulevard from overhead, thanks to Robert Gluckman and chopper pilot Patrick McKernan of KABC TV Los Angeles for providing the bird's eye view.
Ah,
I am over here, of course, with Tina Fey, Amy Poehler, Maya Rudolph. You guys look incredible. I have to say, I heard that yesterday at rehearsals that somebody was having a difficult time walking. I think it might have been Amy, maybe?
Me and you.
And I heard that you guys said if one falls, all fall. Is that the plan?
That is the plan, and it could happen.
Those are squad girls.
I love it. And Amy, I hear you're about to direct your first feature with these lovely ladies.
I finished directing it, and it's coming out May 10th. It's called Wine Country, and all these ladies are in it, and it's going to be on Netflix as well as in theaters. So I'm really excited for people to see it. It's a Rachel Dratch, Jonna Gasteyer, Paula Pell, Emily Spivey, us, Jason Schwartzman, Cherry Jones. So it's a great film.
It was super fun.
Really
fun.
How'd she do?
She was amazing. Yeah. As expected.
You were great.
Yeah. It was really fun. It was great to be together, but more importantly, like, to see someone in their element doing what they are loving and what they're so naturally good at was really the biggest treat of it, I think.
So
and drinking wine.
Do we have a lot of wine on Wine Country?
A lot of wine.
Okay. That's all that matters.
Yeah.
Are you guys going to have a lot of wine tonight?
Well, in a couple hours.
Yeah, we're done soon.
They serve wine here, right?
Is early, so we'll start drinking after that.
Perfect. After we do the walk.
Yes.
After we safely get on stage, present, and move on.
Yeah. I don't know how we lost the war on shoes, but we lost the war on shoes.
I got boots on under here.
Ooh, you're so smart.
Wedge boots, ladies. Thank you so much. Have a blast.
Thanks, Rhea.
Thank you.
Let's see what's going on elsewhere on the carpet. And Richard E. Grant is here with me today. How are you feeling?
Absolutely out of body, surreal, jumping up and down inside. I'm standing here calmly talking, and you were like vibrating.
Okay, so I am a little envious of you because you have been taking a journal since you were 10 years old.
Yes, I have.
And so did you write anything last night in preparation for today?
Every day, every single day. It's like I've written a novel practically since this award circuit has begun.
Oh, that's so beautiful for your kids and for the future family. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, so the other fun thing I've heard about you is with Melissa McCarthy,
you
hadn't even really met her until you got onto set.
No, we met for 2 hours on a Friday and we started shooting on the Monday.
And how was
instant,
that?
Instant. She was a nightmare to work with. Very, very difficult woman. But I just had breakfast with her family and jumped on the trampoline in preparation for coming here today.
Oh, really?
Yeah, just to keep it real.
Oh, I love that. Okay, so who are you most excited to see tonight?
Barbara Streisand.
Who?
Barbara Streisand.
Barbara!
Yes.
Where are you, Barbara?
Oh,
that'll
Barbara,
so
can you
great.
Hear me?
All right, let's see who else we got on the carpet. Thank you so much, Richard.
Thank you very much.
We are so blessed, and I am so humbled to have Congressman John Lewis in our presence. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing very well, sir. It's good to be here.
It's so good to have you. You know, you've been portrayed. Civil rights leader have been portrayed in Ava DuVernay's Selma. How important do you think it is for Hollywood to continue to tell these kinds of stories?
I think it is a must for Hollywood to tell this story because only Hollywood could paint the picture and make it real.
Yes, yes. You know, I know this isn't a political event, but I'm just gonna go out on a limb and ask you, with this election cycle coming, for those of us who are in search of hope and a little bit of grace, what advice would you give us, the world, to sort of latch on to something that's hopeful?
I would say to each and every one of us, and especially our young people, that you must never, ever give up or give in.
Yeah.
You have to continue to stand up, and speak out, and get involved.
Eternal vigilance is the price of liberty.
Yes.
Yes.
If you don't have it, you will lose it.
You taught me that. We thank you for being here with us. It's really a gift. Let's see what else is going on the red carpet.
Laura Morano here with the ultimate companion to Hollywood's most iconic event. It's the official Oscar game. Make award predictions, answer trivia, and you could win $50,000. Plus, you'll get access to exclusive backstage photos and videos. Sign up at oscar.com/game and play along with the Oscars live during the show tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC.
We'll be back with more stars and sensational fashions as they make their way down the red carpet. We're coming right back on ABC.
Rockwell. We are here with Brian Tyree Henry.
Hello.
Looking so dapper tonight.
You got a lot of nerve. Look at you. Look at the bling.
Well,
look
thank
at everything. You.
You thank
look
you.
Amazing.
You've got a lot of bling on, too.
And yeah, I'm trying to represent for Spider-Verse. So
yes.
I put on a few webs, a few spiders.
Hey,
to
we
so,
see you.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so you're in three of the hottest films.
Really?
Widows.
Okay.
If Beale Street Could Talk.
Yes.
And Into the Spider-Verse.
Yes.
Holy moly.
It's been a year, right?
I mean, tell me about it.
I mean, I try to find sleep when I can. I don't really know if there's any time for it, but I've been able to work with some amazing people. I mean, Steve McQueen, Barry Jenkins, Viola. You know what I mean? It's all been great. Regina King,
I know,
who I'm out here. If she wins tonight, I might run up and down the aisles and scream and just like, it's going to be great. But I've been incredibly fortunate to be able to do some projects that have really resonated with people, and I want to continue to do that.
And you're presenting tonight.
I'm presenting. I forgot. I am presenting.
What are you presenting?
Best costume design with Melissa McCarthy, another good buddy
of
mine.
Oh, I love Melissa.
Yeah.
Please give her a big kiss for me.
Yeah, we filmed a movie together this year that's coming out on Christmas. And, like, yeah, so us getting to present together is going to be bonkers.
Oh, well, I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
So happy for you.
I'm incredibly proud of you.
Thank
Keep
you,
doing
sweetheart.
Your thing.
Thank
Keep
you.
Doing your thing.
All right, let's see what's going on down the carpet. So Bill, I just got back from Fashion Week in New York. Before we find out if we got any scoop from the designers there, we're going to take a look at a red carpet favorite, Charlize Theron.
Yes, yes. The category is...
I mean, she's been a fashion icon.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. You know, she got that mermaid silhouette. She's done it in many different colors. This is the black, and it flares out with that train. It's so beautiful. Then she does it in a red, and it also has the train, which is so lovely. That color pops on her in such a wonderful way. Then she has that white, and it also does the same thing. And I love the décolletage that's open, the V that sort of accentuates the bosom.
Yes.
And then I like this one because of its futuristic metallic look. It's classic while simultaneously being futuristic.
I also loved her hair with this.
Yeah, it's that up
so
sort
different.
Of classic
little poofy.
Hollywood do.
Fantastic.
So there you have it.
I love it. Well, we're going to check out more red carpet fashions with Billy in just a bit. But right now, I don't know about you, Billy, but I'm curious to see what's going on down there.
Yeah, let's see what shenanigans the children are bringing.
Who's down the carpet?
Some of the most legendary performances in film history came from artists who won Oscars in this next category. Check out the nominees for actress in a supporting role.
Amy Adams, Vice.
I know George is next in line, but after that, who knows?
Marina de Tavira, Roma.
No importa lo que te digan, siempre estamos solas.
Regina King, If Beale Street Could Talk.
You saw him in the police lineup. That was the only time you saw him.
Emma Stone, The Favorite.
I'm on my side, always. Sometimes it's a happy coincidence for you.
Rachel Weisz, The Favorite.
You have become close to Abigail. It is such a shame, but I've had to dismiss her for theft. She is a liar and a thief.
Okay, there are too many to choose from. Thankfully, we have Alicia Malone, who is back with us. Okay, so we have two Oscar winners, a past nominee, and two newcomers to the Academy Awards. Who do you predict is going to win Best Actress in a Supporting Role?
Well, this has been one of the most difficult acting categories to predict because of a couple of surprises in the key awards leading up to the Oscars. You know, normally Oscar nerds such as myself look to the Screen Actors Guild Awards and the BAFTA Awards as being the biggest predictors for this category. But the SAG Award went to Emily Blunt and the BAFTA went to Rachel Weisz for The Favourite. So for that reason, many experts say it could be Rachel Weisz, but I'm sticking with Regina King.
Me too!
For If Beale Street Could Talk. A stunning performance.
Absolutely stunning.
She
and it's her time to win.
It's her time. She's had a long career. And she used every second of her screen time to its full advantage. She has a lot of support. She's won a lot of other awards, so she has a lot of momentum behind her. And what a movie.
What a movie. It was heartbreaking.
Yes.
And beautiful. And, I mean, Baldwin.
Baldwin.
Right?
And Barry Jenkins.
And Barry Jenkins. I mean, it's really stacking up. Hopefully it will win. Hopefully we'll see a win tonight with Regina. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight.
Thank you.
Look stunning, by the way.
You too.
You look like a star.
Thank you.
So we'll look at the lead actor and actress nominees later, and we'll be back with an exclusive interview when we return to the most famous red carpet in the world right here on ABC.
here with two of the leading ladies of one of the biggest films of the night, Roma, which is up for 10 awards. Congratulations to both of you who are up for awards as well. I have to say, Yalitza, congratulations, because you have already made history tonight as the first.
Estás haciendo historia hoy.
As the first indigenous actress to ever be nominated for an Oscar.
Eres la primera mujer de origen indígena en ser nominada para un Oscar.
You represented so beautifully for all the Cleos all over the world. I want to ask you, what is the message that you want to send to your community in Oaxaca who are watching you soar right now?
¿Cuál es el mensaje que le quieres mandar a tu comunidad en Oaxaca que están hoy observando?
Muchas gracias por todo el apoyo que me han dado. Espero estarlos representando de una forma digna.
Thank you for all the support you've given me. I hope I'm representing you with dignity.
And you are, and you are. Thank you both so much. Congratulations, you are already winners. Yes. And let's see who else is on the carpet.
Casey Musgraves, how are you tonight?
Hi, I'm feeling good, and I also love you. I'm a big fan of you, I'm excited to talk to you. Thank you.
So first of all, congratulations on your Grammy wins.
Hey.
Two of them?
Four.
Four.
Who's counting?
I know.
Me, I'm counting.
Oh my God, Golden Hour is so beautiful. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So what brings you to the Oscars tonight?
I'm really excited to be here. This is my first time, and I get to introduce a lovely performance by two Nashville musicians that actually, they work down the street from where I live, Gillian Welch and David Rawlings. They're so talented, and they're doing a beautiful song, so I'm here to present that.
It's so fun to celebrate friends.
I know. It's very fitting. So
you're also a newlywed.
A little bit, yeah.
Okay.
It was October 2017, so sort of about a year. We made it to a year.
Yes, every year is a victory. Every year is a victory for sure. Okay, so who are your celebrity crushes, though? Even though you're newlywed, I need to know.
You know what? I really kind of just like still stuck on Joaquin Phoenix and Walk the Line.
Yes.
That era, Joaquin Phoenix, hello.
Oh, heartthrob. Okay, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
Let's see what's going on down the carpet.
Louis Fertel here, reminding you to get your phones ready to play the official Oscar game. Watch the Oscars and play along live as you make predictions, answer trivia, and enjoy access to exclusive backstage photos. You could also win $50,000 in the grand prize drawing. So get in on the fun by signing up to play at oscar.com/game. And be sure to check out our Oscars All Access Red Carpet Live stream on Twitter, where the nominees can answer your questions live.
Joining me now is the lovely Constance Wu in this incredible marigold dress that I am in awe over. You look fantastic.
So good to see you.
How are you?
Good. How are you doing today?
I'm great, but you're even greater. You're presenting today.
Yes, and I have such an exciting category. So, best original song, so I'm very excited about
that. Fun. Okay, so your director from Crazy Rich Asians said that this wasn't just a movie, it was a movement. What do you feel about that?
Well, because of the historic significance of our movie, the fact that Hollywood hadn't invested, a major studio hadn't invested in a movie starring an Asian American person in over 25 years. I think our box office success and how much people enjoyed the movie.
Loved it.
Yeah, it spurred on a movement for people to tell these stories and find this audience. And really celebrate what it means to be Asian or Asian American, Asian wherever you are. So that's how it's a movement.
It's so much fun. Now, you've always sometimes made tough decisions to stand in your voice and you know, say what you feel and rise above. How would you encourage others or inspire others to do the same in their lives?
Yeah, I mean, going through being an actress, a struggling theater actress in New York, there is a lot of adversity you face. And I've always found that if you stop thinking about the result or the product or the job, and you just think about your love for what you do, and you reconnect to that, and you reconnect to your creativity, you feel rich in a way that doesn't require money, because it's you feel a wealth of meaning in your life, and that keeps you going when there's adversity.
I love it. Crazy Rich?
Crazy Rich Asians? Two of those things.
Hey. Crazy Rich. You are fantastic.
Okay, thank you so much.
Nice to see you. Have fun tonight.
Thank you.
More interviews with tonight's nominees and incredible fashions are on the way. Oscars live on the red carpet. We'll be right back on ABC.
Oscars live on the red carpet on ABC. Brought to you by the uncompromising Cadillac SUVs.
Okay, I'm fangirling out right now because we have the genius comedian of all comedians, Melissa McCarthy.
Hi there.
Congratulations on your Oscar nomination.
Thank you.
Not just a comedian, a dramatic actor. We hear that you thought Lee was like an armadillo. Is that true?
I did say that quite a bit. I just thought she kept everything so protected. I'm very out and open. I don't really like hide much, and I thought everything about her, I kept thinking armadillo.
Do you use that technique with a lot of your characters?
I think something always kind of occurs to me, like where you carry it from or how they're kind of, I think a lot about defense mechanisms.
Yes.
I really do. I'm like, even when someone's so chatty and positive, why? I always wonder the why.
So the door knocker thing, if you win an Oscar, for real, girl, you gonna make it a door knocker? That's a heavy door knocker.
I'm gonna get a bigger door.
I'm sure you got a big door with all them jewels, honey. It's good to see you. Congratulations and good luck tonight.
Thank you.
We are gonna go back and see what the children are serving us with their looks on the red carpet.
Who do I?
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Willem Dafoe.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm great. This is fun.
Fourth nomination.
Yes.
Eternity's Gate. What was it about Vincent Van Gogh that intrigued you so much to want to do this?
Well, it was more about the setup that Julian Schnabel, who I knew, is a great painter. He's a great filmmaker. He's been thinking about Van Gogh all his life. And I knew his take would not be a traditional biopic. So I didn't know who. You don't know a character until you do it, really. But I knew the setup was good, and Julian had special information about him. Also, I knew I would have to paint, which was a new experience for me. So that really was part of the initial attraction.
So it's the challenge that gets you excited.
The challenge, learning something new. Certainly Van Gogh, I had read his letters even before this, and they're very inspirational and very, very articulate, a very compelling figure.
What's your take on him now, having played him?
Well, it's changed because I don't subscribe totally into the, you know, the cliche of the tortured unknown artist. I saw also he had a lot of joy. He connected with his work. He lost himself in his work. He had a great sincerity and a great desire to be useful, something you don't always think of him, you know? So it was an incredible experience to learn how to paint, to be in the places that he was painting, and a beautiful film that really changed how I see.
Fantastic. Well, incredible performance.
Great. Thank you so
much. Thank you so much. Good luck tonight and have a blast.
Right. Thank you. I will.
We're going to look down that red carpet and see who else is around.
Okay. All right. We are here with the one, the only, the very dapper Trevor Noah.
How are you doing, Elaine?
I'm doing good. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm fantastic. Are you kidding me? We're at the Oscars.
It's not
too hot. It's a fantastic event. Everyone looks amazing. This is my first time, so I'm just soaking it all in.
I know. So this is your first Oscar.
Yes.
So I wanted to do a little film trivia.
Oh,
because
Lord.
I actually learned something about you that I did not know.
Okay.
Lupita shared it with me on the plane ride over here,
believe
it or not.
Oh, okay.
So your fans might not know this, but you actually have a cameo in one of the biggest films of all time, Black Panther.
Yes, yes. A lot of people don't know this.
A lot of people don't know. Why aren't you screaming this from the rooftops?
Well, because
tell them what the role is.
Well, humility is one of my strong suits, and so I try not to tell people that I was a big part of Black Panther's success. I played the navigation system voice for the spaceship. And
would they be without you?
They wouldn't go anywhere. But where does T'Challa go? Turn left where? You don't know. And he flies really far. So without that voice, I think really the film itself wouldn't have gone anywhere, because I mean that was the most important part. And that's the kind of thing I look for in a role. Is something where I get to support everyone without any of the credits. That's what I'm looking for in life.
Okay. Let's go back to Lupita for a second and your future in film, because you actually have a really huge film coming out soon. Well, I don't know how soon it is, but you did cast Lupita to play your mother in the film adaptation of your life.
I wish I cast Lupita. Lupita phoned me, read my book, and said...
Lupita called
from Black Panther, and she phoned me and she was like, I'm your mom. And I was like, okay, yes. but what does that mean? And she said, oh, I read your book, and we're making a movie, and I'm your mom. And I was like, yeah.
Listen, what Lupita wants,
when Lupita calls you and says she's doing something, this is an Oscar winner who's telling you that she, yeah, so we're making the movie, and Lupita says she wants to play my mom, which is amazing. I think she'll be great at the job. And we're putting the film together based on the book, and I'm really excited for it.
Well, good for you for listening to a woman who knows what she wants.
I have to. That's what my mom taught me to do.
This is fun. You want to hang out with me all night?
I'd be here the whole day.
All right. Well, thanks, Trevor. I'll let you go. I know you have some
parties to go
to. Thank you so much.
I'm sad that I have to let you go. This is fantastic, by the way.
Thank you.
This is gorgeous.
Thank you so
much. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. All right. Let's see what else is going down on the red carpet, guys.
And now I get to hang out with Mr. Billy Porter as we check out some of those breathtaking looks. Here we go.
All right. Let's see.
What do we got?
The category is, pretty in pink.
My goodness.
That's Gemma Chan, and she's serving us a train from the neck. Look at that color. And
Casey
Musgraves, fresh off of snatching all those trophies at the Grammys, including Album of the Year. Oh, that shoulder moment. And Helen Mirren, she's always killing it and slaying it.
Breathtaking.
That pink is just luminous on her. That cut is fabulous.
I love it. All right, more insight from Billy is coming up, but let's get back to the action further down the red carpet.
Hello, America. We are here with Hollywood's brightest young star and someone I love dearly, Amanla Stenberg.
Hey, girl.
You look incredible.
You look incredible. Look at
We're serving boomerang realness.
I know, right? We really the
swishing tonight. Let's talk about your work. The Hate U Give was one of the most talked about films of the year. And you delivered a really, really impressive performance. Tell me what it was about this particular project that drew you to it.
I think what it was just the film's power to use the medium of film and use the platform that Hollywood has to speak to experiences that are not always given a platform. And that's like what's really interesting to me is that intersection where we're able to watch something that's entertaining and that makes us laugh, makes us cry, but also speaks to an experience that maybe is sometimes buried in the shadows very intentionally.
Absolutely.
And so, yeah, that's what it was about. And I also just read Angie Thomas's book and I fell in love with it. And so that was really moving. Just even to be a part of it was kind of like a dream come true.
Well, I can't wait to see what else you do next. I know you are multi-talented. You're also a musician. One day you want to be a director. The sky is the limit for you, Amanla.
Thank you.
So proud of you. Thank you for joining me.
Yeah,
of course. Have fun today.
Thank you.
All right, let's see what else is going down on the red carpet.
This year's race for Best Actor in a Leading Role includes a past winner, three men with multiple nominations, and an actor celebrating his first nod. Let's check him out.
Christian Bale, Vice.
It takes Don down or not. You are the president.
Bradley Cooper, A Star is Born.
Having something to say, and a way to say it so people listen to it, that's a whole other bag.
Willem Dafoe, At Eternity's Gate.
I'd like to find a new light for paintings that we haven't yet seen.
Rami Malek, Bohemian Rhapsody.
No, I decide who I am. I'm going to be what I was born to be.
Viggo Mortensen, Green Book.
I got no problem being on a roll with you, but I ain't no butler. I ain't ironing no shirts, and I'm not polishing nobody's shoes.
Oh, those were some outstanding performances. TCM's Alicia Malone is back with her thoughts on this race. So, who do you think's going to take home the gold?
Well, it's so interesting that when you look at the nominees, four out of the five actors are playing real people. And as often happens with Oscars, it's all about transformation. So whether it's Willem Dafoe transforming into the artist Vincent van Gogh or Bradley Cooper into a singer, you know, but the two biggest contenders for this category are the two biggest transformations. Christian Bale into Dick Cheney for Vice, unrecognizable under all that makeup, and Rami Malek into Freddie Mercury for Bohemian Rhapsody. Such an incredible performance. It only took me a couple of minutes of watching that film that I completely forgot that I was watching Rami Malek. And out of all the actors nominated tonight, he's the one with the first time Oscar nomination to his name. And I think he could take it. I'm predicting Rami Malek will take home Best Lead Actor tonight for Bohemian Rhapsody and put his Oscar next to his Emmy.
final answer. All right, Alicia, thank you so much.
Thank you.
There is one last acting category to go to, and that is Best Actress. So is Lady Gaga going to win? Alicia will be back with her thoughts. More of tonight's nominees and their eye-catching red carpet looks are on the way. And in just a bit, we're going to go inside the Dolby Theater for some exclusive interviews live on ABC. Stay right there. How you feeling here with James McAvoy tonight?
Jet lags, nervous.
Where'd you come from?
Excited. Came from London.
Ah, London. Okay, so you're a bona fide movie star.
Oh, thank you very much. I think you're the first person to ever say that,
no.
So I will give you hundreds of English pounds.
Okay, I'll take it. I'll give you my address later.
Okay.
But you also are a theater actor, darling.
I am a theater actor, too.
And yes. So do you still get the jitters before you go on stage?
No, I do my own version of it. My nervous reaction, my reaction to nerves, is to become sleepy.
Sleepy.
So, I know, it's really weird. So before the first night and everybody's really nervous and vomiting and all that kind of stuff, I can be found usually in the wings in a dark spot, lying against the wall or on my back, dozing.
Okay, I'm a stomach sleeper. Do you have to have it like cold or warm?
I prefer a room temperature, comfortable temperature, and I like to sleep on my back. If I'm sleeping on a hard surface, which is usually what I'm doing in the wings, I'd like to sleep on my back, just flat with a book underneath my head.
Wow. All right. We got to get that on social media.
Okay. I don't know. America needs to know this.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
All right. See what's going on down the carpet.
One of my favorite actresses of all time, Miss Glenn. Close is standing before me.
Billy.
How you doing,
You're
honey?
My Broadway brother.
I know. It's so good to see you. And congratulations.
Thank
you look
you.
Amazing.
Thank
it
you.
Took 14 years to make this movie.
It did. Yes, it did. The producers wouldn't say, wouldn't take no for an answer, and they kept at it. And 14 years later, it was made.
And there were a lot of women behind the camera.
A lot
How
of women.
How did that feel?
It felt wonderful.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm all for the team.
Yes.
And the fact that our two writers, our composer, our costumer, our editor, and many more were women. But it was all a great team, men and women.
That's amazing. We got to talk about this dress. You got to tell us who made this dress. Capes are back. I was a part of that. But look at this. Look at it. It's unbelievable. Tell us about it.
This is made by Wes Gordon at Carolina Herrera.
Yeah.
And he made it especially for me. And it has 4 million beads.
4 million
yes.
beads, darling.
And it weighs 42 pounds.
42 pounds. This is how you come to the Oscars. This is how you do it. We thank you so much. Good luck tonight.
Thank
I'm rooting for you. You are my favorite.
Thank you, Billy. So good to see you.
We're going to go back to the red carpet and see what the children are serving us.
Well, it is ladies' night over here. We have nominee Amy Adams, who brought along
my mom, Catherine, my sister Julie, and my sister Anna.
Hi.
Hi. And we have my daughter Aviana and my niece Lily back in the hotel. So hi, girls. Aww. Love you, sweetie.
Hi.
Yeah.
How fun to get to experience this with your family.
It is. It's my first time bringing them, and it's super exciting, and I'm looking forward to us having a really fun time tonight.
How was glam for all of you today?
Oh, getting ready?
Yes. Is it fun or stressful?
A little of both, but definitely memorable. Yeah.
And you must be incredibly proud of your daughter.
There's not even words. I mean, Amy's just amazing. Just amazing.
I love how Amy's on Camille duty right now from your other character, right? You're being the journalist right now, helping me with the microphone.
True. Yeah, exactly. Hopefully I'm going to have a better day than Camille has. So.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
You did a fantastic job transforming into Lynn.
Thank you.
How much of your own opinions about somebody do you kind of infuse into a character?
I really try to keep my personal opinions separate. I mean, of course, I'm going to have them, but I really do have to separate, and through research, I get to know the person. So to embody somebody, I really think it's important to keep judgment out of it. And so I like to approach them as I would a friend.
Great. And you're all ready for a big night?
Of course.
Yes, we are.
So I'm going to let you guys go off and have a little bit of fun. Thank you so much.
Thank you so
nice
much.
To see you as always.
Nice to see you too. Have fun tonight.
We're going to see who else is down that red carpet. Surprise us.
Love you, Lily.
Aquaman himself and Miss Lisa Bonet. How are you guys doing tonight?
Are having a lovely time.
It's our first time, man.
Yeah. It's your first time at the Oscars?
First time at the Oscars. Okay. Oh, well, it's my first.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay. Did you guys color coordinate tonight? Was this on purpose?
We have the honor of wearing Karl Lagerfeld.
Oh,
he
great.
Designed Jason's tux personally for him.
Beautiful.
And this is from his last couture collection from Fendi.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
What a great way to honor him tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, so Aquaman has been so much fun. What did the kids think when they saw it? Your kids in specific, come on.
They were blown away.
Yeah.
They had a great time. And I hadn't seen it until they saw it, so it was a very special moment I'll remember forever. But they're very proud of me, and my daughter was... they both were very proud of me. It was a beautiful moment.
I'm happy to hear that. Yeah. Okay,
I'm pretty sure Wolf cried when he thought you got hurt.
He did.
Yeah. Really? That's amazing.
I'm like, I'm right next to you, buddy.
Oh, like, I love that. Papa. Like, okay, one thing I've got to get out of you. I got to get a haka move. I got to get, like, one haka move. Like, come on.
Just get it.
Oh, yes. All right. Thank you so much to both of you.
Thank
Have
you
so
very
much,
much
fun tonight. Let's see what's going on down the carpet.
There's only about a half hour to go before the start of the big show, and this is the only place to see Ryan Seacrest making a special appearance inside the Dolby Theater with some of tonight's nominees. He's joining us next on ABC.
From high above Hollywood Boulevard, thanks, of course, to chopper pilot Patrick McKernan and Robert Gluckman from KABC-TV Los Angeles for that amazing look at the arrivals. Welcome back to Oscars Live on the red carpet. And look who made his way up to our stage. Our friend Ryan Seacrest.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Had some fun tonight?
Double duty.
Double duty, man.
You made it over here.
I like to hustle.
I was worried.
It's great to join you here on ABC for the only live broadcast from the carpet until showtime.
Right. It is just 30 minutes to the start of the 91st Oscars. And if you're at home just joining us, this is the only place to see our exclusive coverage.
That's right. We've got the glamour, the excitement, the pre-show jitters. I would actually have more jitters if I wasn't winded from running down the carpet and making it up the stairs here to be with you.
Well, I'll let you get settled in because there's somebody here who wants to talk to you.
I see him over your shoulder.
So I'm going to head on out, and okay. I'm going to let him come on in. Here
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Myers.
Hi, how are you?
Great to see you.
Good to see you.
Mike Myers, everybody.
Hello. How are you?
Well, we have to talk about when you signed on to play this role in Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yes.
You didn't see the script. You got a phone call, and you said, I'm in.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it. They said, would you like to be in a movie called Bohemian Rhapsody? It's about Queen and the life of Freddie Mercury. And I said, yeah, I'm in. And they said, don't you want to read the script first? And I went, I will read the script, but I'm in. Don't
Have you ever signed on to something without reading the script before?
No.
This
never.
Was a first.
No, of course
a good
not.
Choice.
No, I just, I did read the script. I was moved to tears. I thought it was fantastic. And it's just a fantastic celebration of Freddie Mercury and his decision to declare who he was going to be himself, you know? And audiences have really loved this film. And just having people come up to me in tears saying how much it meant to them and just kind of a magical. And Rami Malek is just, I never got to meet Freddie Mercury, but I felt like I did making this film, so.
What impressed you most about Rami?
What impressed me about Rami is that he stays in character all day, which is, I tend to as well, because it's hard to wind down and then wind back up. But he's first of all, he's a lovely man, one of the nicest guys I've ever met. What impressed me is he caught the spirit of what I thought Freddie Mercury was going to be, which is just a brilliant artist, just a really great artist. And it was very moving. It's one of those, how did I get here, you know? I used to listen to Queen in Toronto. I made a movie, put the song in, and here I am.
You made magic. Congratulations.
I can't believe it.
Great to see you. Let's go to Elaine down the carpet. Elaine.
All right, as the activity on the red carpet winds down, sort of, it's still kind of wild back here, let's go ahead and recap some more of the outstanding looks that we have seen tonight.
All right. The category is Hall of Mirror Realness. with Miss Jennifer Lopez. Look at that body.
Fire.
She's going to be 50 this year. She's telling the world, I'm going to be 50 this year. That's awesome. Serena Williams always looking stunning.
Stunning.
That color. You know, I'm loving the silhouette, the hourglass silhouette, the bodies.
So chic,
and
so
Emma
sleek.
Stone looking like Barbarella. She's giving us Barbarella realness this evening. It's so awesome. Ka-ka.
I think we're having a little too much fun out here, Billy. Thank you so much for joining us. Now let's check out who else just hit the carpet.
Okay. All right, want to welcome a nominee tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, lead actor nominee, Rami Malek. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Well deserved, my friend.
I'm feeling good. It's a moment you'd only dream about, of course. I think, you know, as a kid, you grow up thinking, I just want a job as an actor. Will
sure.
that even happen? So to be here on this scale is something I couldn't have imagined in my wildest dreams, and it is really beautiful.
You captured so much of Freddie. You captured his physicality as well. What tools did you use to really learn how to become him?
I watched him as much as I possibly could. Anything that was archival footage, I would listen to him on the radio. I would see how he would talk to people who were just serving him, you know, a vodka tonic or
yeah.
something. But then I would go and every performance, I would just see how he was so spontaneous and effortless and not choreographed. And the one thing he was, and I've thought about this today, if ever I get up on that stage, is the ability to look at everyone in the audience and make them feel so comfortable with themselves. And I had the help of so many people, a movement teacher who just taught me how to just articulate myself
Listen,
like that.
He said when he walked up here, he said, I just want to dance tonight. Well, you got the move, so get out there and dance.
All right.
And I hope it's a celebratory dance.
I will. It's great to see you.
Great to see you, Bob.
Thank you very much.
Ashley, over to you.
Jennifer Hudson here performing I'll Fight Tonight. How excited are you tonight?
You know, it's always a pleasure to be at the Oscars.
Yes.
So I'm just happy to be here. Being here is like winning alone, and to be able to sing a song like that, it's a dream.
And you've also won an Oscar for Dreamgirls.
Yes.
Where do you keep that statue?
Well, I keep it in my home on its own mantle, and it says, ha, ha.
I'm going to be right there with you.
I like that.
Okay, so do it for the Curvy Girls. Uh-huh. Who are you wearing tonight?
L.A. Saab Couture.
Oh, and you look ravishing.
Thank you. You do, too.
Thank you. Red is so your color.
Thank you.
It's such a pleasure to meet you.
Nice
Thank you so
you.
Much. I can't wait to see you perform.
Thank you.
All right, let's see what's happening on the carpet.
Well, look who I found. Mark Consuelos and a familiar face, Kelly Ripa.
Hi. Hey,
I love your jacket.
Thank you very much. You guys look so stunning together.
We,
terrific.
We
you
are
made
very
a good
excited.
Choice.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
We're very excited to be here. Very excited to take our show inside the
That's
Dolby
right.
Theater
That's
tomorrow.
Right. Coming up tomorrow morning, we will be live early. Tonight, you'll be inside with interviews. You'll see tomorrow on the show, right?
First thing they see when they get that statue is my face.
But I hear you brought tequila to really loosen them
yes,
up a little
that's
bit.
That's right. That's right. So tune in for that.
So tune in. Make sure you check it out. Yeah, I'll be in there in just a little bit as well with some interviews right up until showtime. Great to see you both.
Great to see you. Thanks. I'll see you. Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
And to Billy now.
Bye.
All right, I'm going to try not to fangirl out right now, but Ooh. You know, Jordan Peele is standing next to me, y'all. Wow. What's going on, my brother?
What's going on,
you
Billy?
You looking smoking tonight.
Oh, stop.
Them Tom
no,
Ford
you,
glasses.
You killed this one. You killed it today.
Yeah, this is not about me, though. So hey. We're going to talk about you.
All right.
What did you say to Spike when you pitched Black Klansman?
I said, look, hey, this is a movie about a black man that infiltrates the KKK. And that was basically all I needed to say.
I mean,
come on. What an amazing tale.
Amazing.
What an amazing story. And he was the only person to do it.
Yeah. So, Get Out,
mm-hmm.
last year's Oscar winner, and Black Klansman both have inventive ways of commenting on race in America.
That's right.
What would you like your films and your work to contribute to the conversation?
Well, you know what? I think we can have important conversations. Oh,
I
just
know.
Came. I'm
it's
sorry.
Lit. It's lit.
See, that's more.
Somebody
that's more,
more
important
famous than
me.
Showed up.
And me. That's not hard. Oh, and Helen Mirren.
Snap. Well, work it out.
Okay. Work it out. I want to make movies that, you know, that contribute to the conversation and are fun to watch.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes. Entertainment simultaneously.
Yes.
With teaching the children.
Movies that you can scream at the screen and participate.
That's awesome. Well, we thank you. Thank you for sharing this time with us. And enjoy yourself tonight. I'm rooting for y'all.
All right, man.
And now we're going to go back to the red carpet to see who's clicking and popping down it.
The stars are arriving for their big night, and we've got the ultimate companion for your viewing party, the official Oscar game. Make award predictions and trivia and get access to exclusive backstage photos and videos. You could also win $50,000 in the grand prize drawing. Sign up to play at oscar.com/game. The fun begins as soon as the curtain rises.
Familiar faces on the red carpet. Alex and Jen, great to see you both look amazing tonight.
Thank you, so do you. Thank you.
Everybody was talking earlier about all the stars coming tonight who are nominated, but so many people were saying they're just excited to see you two on the carpet. So I know you're not nominated, you're presenting, but there's a lot of people looking forward to seeing you.
Some of those presenters, you know.
Yeah. Well, great to see you guys. Have fun tonight.
Good to see you, too.
Thanks, Ryan.
All right. Appreciate it. Coming up later tonight, American Idol's bringing a special performance from a Hollywood rooftop overlooking the Oscars ceremony. It features some of the incredible talent you'll meet on our premiere next Sunday at 8, 7 Central right here on ABC. We're back with Oscars live on the red carpet. The titles of the Best Picture Oscar winners adorn the limestone portals here on Awards Walk, heading into the Dolby Theater. Another winner will join those classics tonight. The stars still making their way up this grand staircase. The doors to the orchestra section are just beyond the top of the stairs. And before I take you live inside for all the action, let's go back down to the carpet.
All right, I am here with Bradley Cooper, everybody. Hi. A Star is Born.
Oh, I did it again. I'm stepping on your dress.
You got to step on the star.
Sorry.
It's okay. You can step on my dress all day long. I loved the film.
Thank you so
much about this film, but I don't know if you get enough credit because not only did you direct, you starred in it, you produced it, you performed in it, but you also wrote like half of the music. I waited till the end credits in the theater because I was like, was it really him performing? I felt like there was something to wait for. And when I saw your name in the writing credits, what didn't you do?
Well, I mean, there was a great group of people that I worked with. And, you know, yeah, we everybody did a lot. But yeah, I did a lot, yeah.
So, did you do craft service too, Bradley?
No, Tony was amazing. Well, Tony was catering, yeah.
Well, great, great work.
Yeah, thank you.
I loved every second of it. And I know you have a big night you're going to perform tonight.
Yeah.
Nervous?
That's so surreal that I just said, yes, yeah, we will be performing tonight. But yeah, we will.
All right.
Yeah, I'm really excited, actually.
We look forward to hearing it.
I'm very excited.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
You're going to be fantastic. Thank you so much. Let's head over to Elaine.
Okay, we've covered the nominees for actor and actress in a supporting role and lead actor. Now, here are the amazing women nominated for actress in a leading role.
Chalitza Aparicio, Roma.
¿Sabes? Se parece a mi pueblo. Claro, allá está seco, pero se parece.
Glenn Close, The Wife.
I had very low expectations about what I could achieve as a female writer.
Olivia Colman, The Favorite.
It's my estate. I'm the business estate. Did she actually send me her maid?
Lady Gaga, A Star is Born.
They're just staring at you, listening to your record, going, oh, you sound great, but, you know, you don't look so great.
Melissa McCarthy, Can You Ever Forgive Me?
And how is it that I'm supposed to do that, Marjorie? I'm a 51-year-old woman who likes cats better than people.
All right, this category is such a tough call. I can't even pretend to predict a winner here, but luckily we have TCM host Alicia Malone, who is here to size up the competition. All right, who will be the favorite? No pun intended.
Well, it's going to be close, pun intended, because Olivia Colman does have a lot of support for her brilliant role as the Queen. She's hilarious in The Favorite, but it has to be Glenn Close's year. This is her 7th Oscar nomination. She's currently the actress with the most Oscar nominations without any wins, but that's going to change tonight. And it will be poetic if it's for The Wife, because that's all about a woman getting long overdue recognition for her body of work. Glenn Close's first Oscar nomination came in 1983 for her very first feature film role in The World According to Garp from 1982. So that means for almost four decades, she's been delivering these really complex, interesting female characters on a big screen. It's her time.
She's paid her dues.
Yes.
And at this moment in the women's movement, I think the world is ready.
Exactly.
Right?
We need to celebrate.
I'm rooting for her as well. Thank you so much, Alicia. Now, we're going to head back to the carpet for more action.
Oh, my God. I am so fanning out right now. We got another guest right here. The master of cinema, Mr. Spike Lee.
What's up, Billy? How you doing?
What's going on in all your purple?
It's popping tonight. It's popping.
Sartorial splendor.
Yes, Oswell Boateng.
Yes.
My brother.
Yes, I know that's right. So listen, we heard that you cast John David without an audition. How did you know he was the one?
Well, when he was 6 years old, he was in Malcolm X. He's a very
good.
Yeah, so he had one line. My name is Malcolm X, but I just had a feeling it was my Spidey, Brooklyn Spidey sense. I just knew he could do it.
And
he came through.
That's awesome. So you've been at the forefront of telling stories of disenfranchised people and helping us to rise above into the mainstream. What would you tell young artists today coming up who want to be the next Spike Lee? What advice would you give?
They should be themselves. Be themselves to get the next Spike Lee. But they got to put the work in.
Yes.
You know,
it's hard.
It's work,
all
man.
About the work.
It's hard work. Is
it's
this easy?
All about
is
the
this
work.
Stuff easy?
No, it's not. No,
Dang,
it's not.
You got to put the work
every
in.
Every single day.
You got to hit it. 24/7, 365. Be committed, dedicated, and
Even when people aren't listening. Thank you so
Believe
much.
Believe in yourself.
And what's the last six? The six words that you had at the pitch. What was that six words?
Oh. Black man infiltrates Ku Klux Klan. That's what Jordan Hill told me. I said, I'm in. My man.
I love that. Thank you, Spike.
Thank you.
Thank you. Enjoy. I'm rooting for you.
All right.
The mad dash has begun for the stars to get from the red carpet to their seats inside the Dolby Theater. For the first time, Ryan will take you into the VIP section for some exclusive interviews next on ABC.
Oscars live on the red carpet on ABC. Brought to you by the uncompromising Cadillac SUVs.
Welcome back to Oscars Live on the red carpet. We're counting down the minutes to the start of the show. Joining me now, a nominee tonight for his performance in Vice, last year's winner for his supporting role in Three Billboards, Sam Rockwell.
There he is.
How you doing?
2 years in a row.
I know.
Congratulations.
It's great. Thank you. Thank you.
When you step back in this theater where I watched your speech last year, what feelings do you have?
Definitely very nostalgic and, like, you know, it's surreal. It's an outer body experience. You know, you're just trying to be present and breathe and, you know, all that stuff.
I remember when you were walking up the stage, you dedicated your win to Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yeah, that's right.
Tell me about that friendship.
You know, I didn't hear the mic, so I didn't know if they had heard it, actually. So I said it twice. But I was, he was a dear friend. He was a... He directed me in a play, and he was a great actor, great inspiration, but he was also a dear friend of mine and a big inspiration to me, you know, as an actor.
You did such a great job with W. What was the most challenging part of taking on this role and making it so authentic?
I guess just, you know, doing this with your mouth all the time.
Yeah.
It was kind of a lot. Okay. And
Let's see that.
Kind of just, you know, that was a lot.
Well,
yeah.
Masterful job.
Thanks,
good
man.
Luck tonight.
Thank you.
I know
Thanks.
Where your seat is. It's right by Leslie Bibb.
Yeah, that's right. That's okay. Right. Tyler Perry. That's
good
right.
Luck. We'll see you later. Thanks. We've highlighted the acting categories. Let's take a look at the films in connection for the biggest award of the night. Here are the nominees for Best Picture.
Black Panther. Black Klansman. Bohemian Rhapsody. The Favorite. Green Book. Roma. A Star Is Born.
Tell Fife.
And they are the eight movies from critical to popular favorites. They'll be saluted on the big show tonight by some special guests, some of whom have never appeared on the Oscar stage before. Someone who has been on the stage, collecting her Oscar last year for her performance in I, Tonya. Presenter tonight, Allison Janney. Allison, who's talking to somebody across the room.
Talking to Greg Williams, who takes those incredible pictures. And I was like, this is a great picture of me and Ryan.
Get it. Great to see you.
Honey, it's great to see you too.
Winning last year, I remember we spoke the morning after on our show about it. You were still feeling the excitement. What was that moment like for you to be up there for I, Tonya?
I was just reminiscing and realizing when they called my name, that was the most relaxing moment of the evening for me. Everything leading up to it was frenetic and out of body, and I was not on the ground. And when they called my name, I sunk into the ground and was so grateful. And then it was a great moment.
I remember you saying you did not see it coming.
Well, no, I knew I had been winning for the role of Lavanna, but you know how you get in your mind, you go, I thought, well, the chances are I won't win because the last one, and I just was psyching myself out, and there were so many great performances also, that I just thought, you never know, there's always a, you know, someone you think it's going to go one way and the Oscars go the other way, and I thought, it wasn't a sure thing for me in my mind. I thought that was dangerous to be that way.
Well, I know you've been invited over the years, but last year was your first time actually coming to the show, wasn't it?
Yeah, I thought I'm not going to go to the Oscars until I'm nominated. Yeah. That's what I told myself, because I've grown up watching the Oscars for, 30 some odd years. So to be invited and nominated was...
And winner. Well, great to see you.
Ryan,
take care. Enjoy the show tonight. All right, thank you very much, Allison. Moments you won't want to miss from stars of blockbuster movies are on the way. And guys, heard the rehearsal. It's very exciting. Queen is going to rock you from the top of the show. Adam Lambert will be up there with all of Queen. A big night. The stars, as you can see, are about to take their seats, checking their text messages for one final time before it all begins. You see Trevor Noah, Amanda Stenberg there. All of them making their way in for Hollywood's biggest night. The Oscars are live when we come back right here on ABC. Enjoy.